I plan to use GitHub Copilot to help me write unit tests today, but it won't be a walk in the park. It is one pair of shoes to let it generate source code, but it is an entirely different task to use it to generate unit tests. Here comes the hard question. If Copilot is generating code from the surrounding context, and that code must also satisfy unit tests, then isn't it that those unit tests are the context? How can it generate both the context and the code? Will it not prepare and then eat its own dog food? I want to show you that in code. Here is the static class that will accommodate an extension method like a link operator. That will be the method I will try to test using Copilot's abilities to generate unit tests. Oh, Copilot is already trying to guess the operator, but it's not this one. Let me tell Copilot this. Create an empty extension method which returns the last 10 elements of the sequence. The signature is correct, I will accept it. Now, implement the method, I want the body. No, what is this? Come on, return the last n elements from the source? Well, absolutely not. This solution is unacceptable. Here is a problem Copilot is facing. There are unspoken attributes of the source code. Attributes we know as programmers, but I don't think that Copilot is getting right. For one thing, after a long time of using Copilot, I can say that it is not really good with algorithms. I hope that will improve over time, but right now, I'm better than Copilot. The problem with this suggestion here is that it will iterate through the innumerable source once to get its count, and then another time to skip. Well, not every innumerable implementation allows you to walk through it twice. And some of them will allow that, but under the penalty of losing performance, because, for example, this could be the result of a database query. You would run the query twice to execute this operator once. So let me help Copilot pass items through the queue limited to size n. Now, this is better. Now let's unleash Copilot's capabilities. This loop is 100% correct. It's limiting the queue size to n, so through the entire process of passing through the input sequence, the last n elements will always be those in the queue. Good. Now return the items. But no! Copilot is missing the point again. You cannot just return the queue. That would turn this operator into an immediate operator. I have made an entire video on this very problem of creating immediate or deferred link operator, so you can watch that video. And do that if you are confused by what I'm complaining about here. This is the correct solution. Return items as a lazy. Now Copilot is correct, and I will accept this solution. And I want Copilot to help me write the tests. Let me ask it for a unit test in quite a lot of words for these two values of n and an empty sequence. The method must return an empty sequence. Copilot offers a fact. I'm using the xUnit testing framework. There are two kinds of tests there. Facts, which is a simple unit test that doesn't have any parameters. And theories. A theory can receive input arguments, and you can specify several sets of values to try out for that same test. Now, theory, okay. This is the way to pass parameter values to the theory unit test in xUnit. And another test for n equals 5, so far so good, and the test it generates looks correct, I will accept this. So far, Copilot has got my ideas right. I will only rename this variable to sat, system under test, I like it better that way, and give the method a more canonical name. All right. I want a theory where n equals 0, no matter what the input data are, that the last n elements must be an empty sequence. That Copilot wants to talk to me. No! What was this? Add more words? No. Still, Copilot doesn't understand what I want. I would have to type it myself. A theory. Maybe it is onto something. Maybe. Now it's overdoing it. This could be the data, but not so many. Okay, let's cut it short. And look, implementation is totally off. Obviously, at this situation, Copilot doesn't have any idea what I'm expecting from it. Let me try a different tactic. What if I typed the method name instead of trying with comments? It looks better this time. I will accept this. So one possibility is to start off with the test name. That is quite a lot of words anyway, and it also has parameters. That will give Copilot guidance in what I am thinking about, and it might get it right. I think the test data are still giving it headache. This is just not right. N must be greater than the length of the upcoming array. And in these test data, N is 1 and the array has size 2. That is just not what the name of the method says. I don't know why Copilot is acting so badly. Is it so unclear what I want? I wouldn't say so. Also, it comes to mind that I must include the word equal in the unit test's name because n could be greater or equal than the length. Okay. Nothing has changed. This is plain incorrect. Let me type the data myself. I did help it, and Copilot is still not getting the idea. I think I see what's going on. And that is a characteristic of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence, in general, is repeating what it saw. It is much harder for the AI to come up with a unique solution that it never saw than to interpolate or extrapolate the solutions it did see before. So I have given it 1-1, 2-1, and it guesses what? 3-1? No, that doesn't make sense. I have tested that. I want something totally different. So now this is important. One problem Copilot is facing, as I see it, when generating unit tests, is that every next case, as I see it, must be substantially different from anything written so far in this class. And Copilot, it is in its nature, is trying to repeat what was happening before. That is exactly not what I want in unit testing. So I think I will have to write the test data myself. It lacks imagination. It must find test cases that are entirely different and not overlapping with those already written. Let's move on to the next test. I will start from the method's name and signature. And what is this? This signature and implementation? It makes no sense. I really don't like where this is heading. Let me write signature to the end and give the parameters. Well, look, this time Copilot is getting the idea right. Yes, this is what I wanted. Let me ask it for the test data. What is this? This wouldn't even compile. The same two mistakes keep repeating. I have only started and it gets back on track. This compiles and this makes sense. I will accept this test case. And the second attempt is also right. I think it was a strike of luck. But anyway, this gives you guidance. Maybe a good strategy using Copilot to generate unit tests is to write the entire test's signature on your own, give a full detailed name to the method, give the entire parameter list with detailed names of all parameters, and that will give it a sense of what you're trying to do, and it will probably generate the body of that test right. The problem will happen again with the data, with the test data, because you must use your imagination to find corner cases. I think Copilot is not mature enough to find corner cases yet. It's not doing it right, so far as I can see. But anyway, the testing class is over, and we are ready to run the tests. And while the tests are running, please press the like button if you liked this video. That will help me spread the word about it and find more visitors. Thank you. Ooh, a lot of red color here. Here, the two tests with the 0N and non-empty sequence, they seem to be dequeuing from an empty queue. So, this is where I'm dequeuing from the queue, and it looks like, in some cases, the queue was empty. Maybe I could naively try to ask for n greater than 0, which means that count is also greater than 0. If I think about the tests again, only the tests with n equals 0 have failed, so this condition will never be reached. It will never be true. I think it would be better to short-circuit the execution if n is 0. But look, this happens again. This code will not even compile. I cannot accept this suggestion. This Copilot's habit to generate code that doesn't compile is really worrying me. But let's get to running the tests again. Wait for a moment. And this time all the tests are green. They are all passing. We have completed implementing a function and then completed implementing unit tests for that function. The unit tests were there and they found a defect in code. That is wonderful. And I think that we have got to a strategy of using Copilot effectively to write unit tests. Don't try to explain situation to Copilot. Just write the signature of the method that you plan to incorporate, and it will figure it out pretty well, I believe. And also don't expect Copilot to find corner cases for it. It is not capable of doing that yet. And now, an interesting thought. What if I asked Copilot to write tests first? Did someone say TDD? I must give it some thinking. Like this video, subscribe to my channel, and be here when more videos appear. Maybe I will write TDD-style tests using Copilot soon.